Well, hey guys, welcome to an interesting tech chat where I'm going to talk about GoPro and where I think they should be heading, where they're kind of making some mistakes, and a little bit of the history with GoPro that I've got. Now, I do have quite a few, and I'm going to show you what I've got right now. I've got the original GoPro Hero, the Hero 2, the Hero 3. Now this one, the USB connection's broken, so I have to use the battery behind to be able to charge them, but it still works. So the Hero 3, Hero 4, GoPro Session, the original, the very first, the GoPro Session 5. Now we're going to talk about these ones a bit more in a second. And then I kind of skip up to the GoPro Hero 8, and also the GoPro Max 360 camera. Really, really do love this. I'll talk more about this in a future video. So, I love my GoPros. I used to have the 5, 6, and 7, so I almost had the whole collection. I actually sold the 5, 6, and 7 to fund to get the GoPro Hero 8 and also the GoPro Max. So, I like getting the latest ones. Now, so I showed you all those, but there's the GoPro that I like the most, which I think GoPro have done a mistake stopping that range. And it's a GoPro that's really, really popular with the drone, FPV drone world, and that's the Session. I think there is still some time and some place for GoPro to do a new Session. The design, I love this design. Yes, you don't have a screen on the back, but the minimalist size of this, the size of it, they could even make it maybe a tiny bit smaller for the drones, but the concept behind this, I think, is really good. And it's a pity that GoPro stopped doing that, because it's still a very well sought after little action camera that's still FPV for guys that love these. They can't get hold of these. I probably want this one here that I've got in my hand right now. One of my most popular videos on YouTube, actually is my most popular video on YouTube, is my video comparing these two, the original Session to this Session 5. And there wasn't a huge difference. Main thing that the Session 5 could do 4K up to 30, where the original Session could only do 1080p up to 30. So there's some differences there. Of course, the Hero 4 could do 4K up to 30. And the Hero 3 could do 4K, but only at 15 frames a second, which is not very usable. And So that's what I'm thinking about GoPro. I think, look, Hero 8 is really good. I'm really enjoying it. This has got it's got a roll cage cover over the top of it. And I can take these glasses out and I can get some ND filters that will clip into that, which I think is pretty good. So pretty good. So I actually do like the idea of actually having the connections right on it. What I would love to see is someone invent an accessory. Here's an accessory idea, guys. Take this off, because they're only four screws, and invent a attachment that goes onto that bottom, so it replaces these with a tripod mount, because I would love to see a direct tripod mount. And I'm sure if someone out there who's very smart and they make a mod, because these are screwable and replaceable if they did break, though they do feel very sturdy and strong, a lot better than I thought it would. But they could replace those and make a full-on tripod mount, even for the Max, because the Max is using the same concept. And I'm actually really blown away with the Max, what you can do with this thing. Now, I only had a Samsung Gear, I think 2017, the newer version. That was my last time trying a 360 camera, and it was so cool. This thing, I'm really impressed with the quality of the video and photos is really good. I actually do enjoy Hero mode, even though it's only 1080p. The footage looks really good, and the 360 footage, it's so much fun filming and then editing it after. I might go a little bit overboard, but I'll be doing a review on this hopefully sometime soon. So that's the Max. So I've got a few GoPros, and of course my other favorite action camera is the Osmo Action. This is still my most favorite action camera. for the fact that it's got the front screen, and since the latest update, the front screen's virtually got no lag anymore, where before it used to have lag when recording. There's virtually near to no lag, and that's really good. Where I think GoPro has done wrong is what they've done with the Hero 8. Yes, the Hypersmooth 2.0 is, to be honest, a little bit better than the original Hypersmooth. And some of the other little features, I think making it so it's got the built-in lens without being able to take that off, was, like a lot of the people, I think was a silly move by GoPro. But the biggest mistake is their whole modular idea that they brought to the table with this. They didn't come out with the light first, and then they come out with the media mod, which is really hard to get hold of. I think overpriced, and from what I hear, actually not that good. So, and it seems to be, yeah, I just don't know. It will come out before the Hero 9 even gets announced, because just can't seem to get hold of it here in Australia. You can get some pre-orders and order them in online, but most of the stores just can't get hold of it. And actually, I've noticed recently that it seemed to disappear, so I'm not sure if there's been a recall or GoPro have had to go back to the drawing board because of so many problems with that. And also the flip screen idea. It's a novel little idea, but, you know, DJI have shown that you can make an action camera with a front-facing screen, which is, does everything like that. Even the Insta 1R, whatever they call it, which is modular design, can have the screen face forward. So, yeah, I don't know, GoPro. The Hero 8's good. I'm happy I got it. But, to be honest, bring back the session, please. Bring back the GoPro session. Anyway, that's my idea about GoPro. And let's not even talk about the karma. But I think it's great trying to think of new ideas. And some of the ideas on the media mod and stuff like that were not too bad, but too expensive and really didn't add too much to it. So, yeah, it'd be interesting to see what GoPro do with the 8. I personally think they should put a colour screen here, and even if the cameras are slightly a bit wider, change the look of it. And that's another thing I love about the Osmo Action. You can take the cover off here, replace it, and you can put filters on top of it. It's still got heaps of room for that screen. And I think GoPro really, it's time that they redesign the look of the GoPro. Yeah, they redesigned it a bit from the Hero 4, which didn't have a rear screen. You could get the silver version of this, which had a rear screen, which wasn't very popular. And with this, I just think, you know, they're still pursuing with the same LCD screen on the front, which really doesn't add too much to it. If they worked on that, add a proper colour screen in the front, they could really move things a bit forward. I think 4K, believe it or not, 4K 120 or something like that, I really need the change, some specs, add something to it. Because if they do the Hero 9, it's just like Hypersmooth 3.0. Because truthfully, this feels like just a, the way the Hypersmooth works, just feels like a new firmware update. It was really hardware-wise, it's not much has changed here. But GoPro charge you every year for that. So hopefully GoPro look into changing that. Now, I've gone on for about 8.5 minutes, so that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed what you see, what you heard and watched, whatever. Comment down below what you think, and yes, see you in a future video.